gonna be one like we did that intro. So.
Can we get two mics?
That's the problem we're having.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't hear that. So we're going down there. So I'm just introducing myself, and then I'm saying after I introduce myself, I'm just so now
sit
everybody
back.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. People are going to be like, why do you need a piece of paper for that?
We only got one mic, so.
Why don't we both say and enjoy the show? And I'm John Celia, Tony nominated performer. Oh God! So what's your last line? Final round.
Yep.
Thank you. Thanks, Luke.
Hello, everyone. I am Catherine Morgan, guest artist, master teacher, former soloist with New York City Ballet and Miami City Ballet.
Hi, Katie. And hi, everybody. I'm John Celia, Tony nominated performer and honorable YAGP judge.
We are live here at the Straz Center in Tampa, Florida, and we are so excited to be your virtual commentators for this evening's junior final round.
So everybody, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lisette Campos. I am a proud resident of Tampa Bay in the wonderful state of Florida, a super fan of the Youth America Grand Prix, as well as the Straz Center for the Performing Arts. And tonight I have the extra privilege of serving as your mistress of ceremonies.
Yeah, that'll happen.
This year has been one of the most challenging years.
I like this, Catherine.
Me too.
Yeah, I'm getting into this. Would you like this? These chairs? Do you think those would be better? Because these are a little for me. You like these? Sit back, relax. Well,
yeah,
just
sure.
You want those other chairs or this one?
Let's do the other chairs.
Okay. Well, this one.
Performing arts world has been largely shut down, and yet the dancers have persevered.
Yeah, that's at least.
They have trained more in kitchens, in their bedrooms, in the living rooms. They have stayed in shape. The dancers have stayed in focus. They've stayed motivated, and they have stayed committed to their art.
That I can do. I can move.
As a result, more than 5,000 talented young dancers auditioned for the Youth America America Grand Prix semifinals all over the United States of America. YAGP, yes, that deserves an applause. We are thrilled to report to you tonight that YAGP was the only major international ballet competition to keep its stage open throughout the COVID-19 pandemic, offering dancers a chance to dance safely on stage. Some 400 soloists, the best of the best in the United States, have been selected for the finals here in Tampa, the 2021 U.S. season final round. For the dancers, this is the junior women's age division, ages 12 to 14. What you will see tonight is the top finalists in the competition. The dancers will perform in front of our in-person judges, as well as an audience that is joining us here live at the Straz Center for the Performing Arts, as well as virtually. But what makes tonight extra unique is the fact that they will be performing for directors of YAGP international partner schools and scholarship presenters who will be adjudicating virtually from all over the world. So although the format of this year's final round is different, the mission is still the same: to provide talented young dancers with education and performance opportunities around the world. Over the next week, our YAGP partner schools will be finalizing scholarship offers to these young artists, which will be announced next weekend, along with the winners of the YAGP 2021 finals. And then these talented young dancers will disperse to study on these scholarships at the world's leading dance schools. And we want to wish them all well and pause now for a big round of applause for all of them. They're working so hard. So I would want to welcome you to the future of dance that is made possible with the help of some amazing judges that are joining us. Our live judges that are joining us here in Tampa, we have Jose Carayol, who is the head of studio company and trainee program at the Joffrey Ballet. We have Erica Fishbach, the academy director of the Colorado Ballet. We have Aram Manukian, trainee program director of the Alberta Ballet School in Canada. We have Claudio Munoz of the Houston Ballet 2 Master, Ballet Master, the Houston Ballet Academy. We have Sasha Radetsky. She is the director of the American Ballet Theater Studio Company. And someone who is near and dear to all of us here in Tampa, we have Peter Stark, associate director and head of the Boston Ballet School Men's Program, Boston Ballet, and former artistic director here at the Youth America at the Straz Center for the Performing Arts. And we have Gennady Savaliev, co-founder of the Youth America Grand Prix, a studio company teacher at the American Ballet Theater. And certainly, last but certainly not least, here in person, we have our judge is Arancha Ochoa, the director of the Miami City Ballet School. And so I said earlier that what makes tonight so unique is that we have judges joining us as well from around the world. I will be calling out their names so that you can see they are judging live but virtually. We have Jean-Yves Esquier. He is the director of the European School of Ballet in the Netherlands. Our next judge is Deborah Hess. She is a leading faculty member of Canada's National Ballet School. Also joining us virtually is Judge Elizabeth Platel, director of the Paris Opera Ballet School in France. We have Christopher Powner, artistic director of the Royal Ballet School. Christopher Powner, for the mispronunciation. And we have, last but not least, we have Tadeusz Matas. He is the artistic director of the John Cranko School of Stuttgart Ballet in Germany. And so now sit back, relax, and prepare to be amazed. Enjoy.
We will begin tonight's competition with number 208, Crystal Huang, age 12, Nevada School of Dance and the Rock Center for Dance Nevada, Harlequinade.
So Crystal was a Hope Award winner this year in the regional finals, and she is 12. Beautiful job, Crystal. Very nice. That's such a hard variation, ladies and gentlemen. It's one of those very deceptive ones that can be tricky if you don't know ballet.
Thank you.
So Samantha is attending the Bolshoi Academy this summer, and she also loves to volunteer at a dog shelter.
Beautiful, beautiful ending, too.
Aurora Keller, age 12, Southland Ballet Academy, California. Graduation ball.
Aurora Kellogg. So if you'll notice, actually, what we're finding interesting is that Aurora is a lefty. And most women, I would say maybe about 90%, are righties. But she's doing all of her turns to the left side.
Yeah, and the great thing about it is we don't even realize that.
Right.
It just looks smooth as silk.
Number 230, Sophia Angelov, age 12, independent from California, Talisman.
Sophia here has both British and Bulgarian ancestry. Her father is Bulgarian and her mother is British. Number 232, Kennedy Collar, age 12, Nevada School of Dance and the Rock Center for Dance, Nevada, Nutcracker Suite. So Kennedy attends the Rock Center for Dance, and I actually had the privilege of coaching her on YouTube, and she is just a delight. And this solo in particular is quite difficult, so keep that in mind as you're watching this.
Number 234, Adelina Belusco, age 12, Pennsylvania Ballet Conservatory, Pennsylvania, Le Corsair. Number 239, Isabel Yoder, age 13, Next Generation Ballet at the Straz Center, Florida, Paquita.
On point, wouldn't you say?
Yes, absolutely. And she has the home stage advantage.
That's it. She's right here from the Straz Center.
Yes. Number 241, Bella Jones, age 13, Elite Classical Coaching, Texas, Raymonda.
Thank you.
beautiful work.
Yes. Bella was the Youth Grand Prix winner in Dallas this year and attends Elite Cup.
Number 243, Isabella Howard, age 13, Nevada School of Dance and the Rock Center for Dance, Nevada, Walpurgis Nacht. Number 251, Ava Royster, age 13, the Dallas Conservatory, Texas, La Bayadere. Number 254, Madison Bevilacqua, age 13, Timothy M. Draper Center for Dance Education, New York, La Fille Malgarde. Thank you. Number 255, Sarah Savage, age 13, The Art of Classical Ballet, Florida, graduation ball.
One of the hardest things to do is to recover in ballet, and she did a beautiful job of that.
Number 261, Aubrey Parker, age 13, Pavlova Professional Coaching, Texas, Paquita.
Aubrey is a YAGP baby. She has been doing this since she was nine.
Number 262, Charlize Hardwick, age 13, Bayer Ballet Academy, California, Sleeping Beauty.
Thank you.
an interesting variation. It's not one that's typically done from Sleeping Beauty, but I think it's beautiful.
It is. It's from Act Two, correct?
Yes.
Number 268, Anya Donahue, age 13, Evolve Dance Company, California, Coppelia.
So fun fact about Anya is that she loves kayaking and can go right out her door and go right on the river.
Number 272, Lena Mae Kirkheed, age 13, the Ballet Clinic, Arizona, Sleeping Beauty.
She requires a lot of fast, quick feet. She's able to keep up with this tempo really well.
Number 274, Elizabeth Feng, age 13, Morningstar Dance Academy, Georgia, Coppelia.
So Elizabeth attends Morningstar Dance Academy in Georgia.
Number 275,
nature and everything is so precise, but at the same time, it's really long and she is dancing to the back row.
Number 275, Taylor O'Meara, age 13, Master Ballet Academy, Arizona, Harlequinade.
Taylor, in a beautiful tutu, all the way from Arizona, and I hear
and Royal Ballet School.
Great animation, wouldn't you say, Catherine?
Yes, and this solo is so difficult. Is definitely a turner. As you can tell, she nailed absolutely every one of those pirouettes with no problem.
Yeah, she got that extra one in too.
Number 277, Audrey Buchelman, age 13, Denver Academy of Ballet, Colorado, Giselle.
From Colorado. Now, Catherine, would you think she would have an advantage when she's dancing at sea level?
Oh, that's a very good point. Colorado is one of those states that is above sea level, and so it actually helps your stamina if you're training above sea level. Maybe she's finding it easier here.
We'll see.
Thank you.
difficult are they?
It depends on the dancer's feet, but you know what she's actually doing to
Number 279, Nina Holt, age 13, Master Ballet Academy, Arizona, Don Quixote.
Give her props for her props.
Number 284, Sienna Morris, age 13, Ballet Conservatory at Skyra, Florida, Sleeping Beauty.
This, she's been on the TV show Impractical Jokers. Version, and it's no coincidence because one of the master teachers at Skylar is the Ballet Bashkara.
Number 286, Isabel Lehman, age 13, Master Ballet Academy, Arizona, Satanella.
Thank you.
variation's exceptionally long. It's known as a five-part variation, as opposed to a three-part variation, which is the more traditional structure.
Number 288, Isabella Meyer, age 13, Elite Classical Coaching, Texas, Paquita.
Here's Isabella, who hopefully is feeling right as rain. You know, she wants to be a meteorologist, perhaps, after her dance career.
I love that. I love that these dancers are already thinking about life after ballet, because that will happen. Isabella trains at Elite Classical Coaching in Texas.
Number 293, Isabella McCool, age 13, St. Lucie Ballet, Florida, Talisman.
So this is Isabel, and she has a YouTube channel with her dance partner, and they document their partnership and in the studio and out of the studio, so go check that out.
But don't leave our YouTube page just yet.
Do it after the show.
Number 303, Paris Vigos, age 14, Illinois Classical Ballet, Illinois, Satinella.
Paris, who is actually one of six siblings. And look at this great mask. This isn't the kind of mask we're wearing now. This is a more ornamental mask. Siblings are watching me?
Hopefully.
All right.
Number 301, Natalie Steele, age 14, Dimitri Kulev Classical Ballet Academy, California, Talisman.
So Natalie here is a very typical California girl. That's how she describes herself. Loves surfing, skateboarding, and she's apparently also incredibly smart. Loves writing, and I actually worked with Natalie on YouTube recently. I coached her in the solo, and she's just beautiful.
She does look great, Catherine, and one might say she's shredding it. Surfing, how important the footwork is. Except besides wax, she's using rosin.
Yes.
Number 305, Maya McDaniels, age 14, Mid-Atlantic Center for the Performing Arts, Maryland, Paquita.
Maya, looking resplendent in a white tutu. Such authority, don't you think, Catherine? She had written on the bottom of her shoe in that tondu.
That's what we're taught. Now, interestingly, we are looking at some of the comments on YouTube, and some of you are saying about Esmeralda, we have not seen Esmeralda yet. We have not, actually. And to be honest, I'm wondering if that's because of the judges, because the judges tend to get a little bit tired of Esmeralda.
Oh, that's the one with the tambourine, right?
Yes.
I know the dogs don't like that one because of the tambourine.
But we'll see if we come across one, but it's funny because variations go in and out of the room.
Number 311, Juliana Wilder, age 14, The Art of Classical Ballet, Florida, Don Quixote.
So this is Juliana, and she is a Florida girl. She's a homegrown girl here. And
here. So we've got Beauty and Brains. This is another exceedingly difficult song to control. So as you're watching this, just appreciate the stamina.
Number 314, Yana Paneva, age 14, Ballet Conservatory at Skyra, Florida, Diana and Acteon.
And here's Yana, another student of Skyra in Orlando. Fun fact is Yana's from a family of engineers, and she's the first artist.
Number 316, Aaliyah Marie Key, age 14, Maryland Youth Ballet, Maryland, Paquita.
Is Aaliyah, and believe it or not, she zip lines. And she also has an itch for the open road. As soon as the COVID restrictions are over, she plans to take a road trip with her friends.
She does it here too. Yep. Gorgeous. Mm-hmm.
Number 334, Valeria Franco, age 14, Kirov Academy of Ballet, Washington, Don Quixote.
Valeria, she's from Colombia, and she studied at the Kirov Academy in Washington, D.C.
Each foot, everything is out, knowing everyone.
I love her performance quality.
I also love her tutu, but that seems to be a common time with me today.
Number 337, Gwyneth Smith, age 14, Nashville Ballet, Tennessee, Awakening of Flora.
Taking the stage now is Gwyneth. Now Gwyneth is a third generation dancer.
Going back to what we were talking about, trends in variations, Awakening of Flora seems to be one of the most popular ones this year. I've seen it quite a bit, both this one and a second one, the third variation.
Joy Gwyneth in The Awakening of Flora. I've noticed that this variation has a rather long introduction too.
It does. I think it's kind of nice actually. The dancer gets to get out on stage and feel the floor and sort of get into their corps de bras before they even start. I love this one. I think it's great for more lyrical dancers who are not tricksters, which I appreciate. So, I don't know. I actually really appreciate this variation.
We appreciate all your commentary and your illumination, Catherine. Thank you.
Thank you, John. Also, Gwyneth is studying at Nashville Ballet.
Not only for music anymore.
Number 340, Aurora Chinchilla, age 14, independent from Florida, Giselle.
Mm-hmm.
Number 351, Amira Hogan, age 14, Vitaka School for Dance, Texas, Paquita. Number 352, Fiona Poth, age 14, Dimitri Kulev Classical Ballet Academy, California, Awakening of Flora. Thank you. We will have a 20-minute intermission, and then welcome you back to the Act Two, to Act Two, the Stars of Today Meet the Stars of Tomorrow Gala. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Daniel Olbrick, and I just wanted to say a couple words about the incredible Jacques d'Amboise. We lost an incredible icon last week, and Jacques had a profound influence, not just on me, but generations of dancers. Although I didn't get a chance to see him perform at the New York City Ballet, he was responsible for creating roles like the lead in Stars and Stripes, and the lead in Who Cares, and a number of other ballets that are still in our repertory today. As a mentor and friend, Jacques inspired me to give back as much as possible to the next generation of dancers. Every time I was with him, I saw his magnetism, his charisma, and he was truly the Pied Piper of all, and used dance as his ability to connect with people. He made everyone feel important in the room, and his legacy will be with us for the rest of his lives. So Jacques, thank you for touching my life and inspiring me to try to do the best to touch other people's lives. We'll never forget you, and thank you so much for your incredible contribution, your friendship, and your guidance as always. With love and respect, Daniel.
And welcome to YAGP of junior and